consulte a Dr. Cannabis. Encontre tudo sobre cannabis medicinal. Acesse www.doutorcannabis.com.br.
Olá, agradeço muito pela oportunidade de falar com vocês e participar meus conhecimentos. Hello everyone, my name is Yoav Giladi. Today we're going to talk about how to identify a safe cannabis product. I hope you enjoy my presentation. First, let me tell you a little bit about myself. My background is biology and cannabis breeding. I worked at the Agricultural Research Organization, Department of Phytopathology, and I'm originally from Jerusalem, Israel, like Professor Rafael Meshulam, the most famous Israeli researcher in the field of cannabis. He discovered THC and the metabolic pathway leading to the formation of the molecule inside the plant. A decade afterwards, he discovered the anandamide molecule and elucidated the whole endocannabinoidic system, which is an integral system in our body, just like the lymphatic system or the neural system. So I really hope one day Rafi will be awarded with the Nobel Prize that he deserves. Coming back to me, here is a breeding field for cannabis variety containing high amounts of cannabidiol. And doing my past work at several different facilities, I also did an internship in Canada, in Bellevue, in an analytical laboratory. Canada is now leading the field of cannabis export. And I just want to share with you my latest publication about a newly discovered disease that affects the cannabis plant. So just published this year, first author of this discovery about a disease that not only affects tomatoes, peppers, spinach. We discovered a new variety that affects outdoor cultivation of cannabis. It's a single-strand DNA virus, and you can read more about it. Because today we're going to talk about the difference between a good cannabis and bad cannabis for medicinal use. The difference between cannabis and other pharmaceutical drugs is that pharmaceutical drugs are being manufactured from day one synthetically, and cannabis is a plant. It starts its way, grows in greenhouse, in indoor facilities, and then processed into the cannabis product. And there are many, many different practices in order to achieve a good cannabis plant. And because there are so many practices, there are ways that they can go wrong. And today we're going to learn five different ways to evaluate the quality and to ensure the safety of a cannabis product. Because there are many cannabis plants that are that can have a fungi here, for example. Fungi creates toxins which make this product not safe, and also improper storage and mislabeling and many other factors that can harm the product. The first thing we'll talk about is the presence of pesticides. Or pesticides are chemicals that are used in the process of growing in order to ensure that there are no insects that are harming the plant and harming the final product. but the use of pesticides can result in residuals that stay inside the plant flower and afterwards continue to the extraction, and we will get them in the final cannabis product. So here is the way to evaluate using an LC-MS/MS. Here you can see the different pesticides that are being inspected. You can see that everything passed. It's below the limit. So this cannabis product is free of pesticides and safe to be administered to patients. The second thing to look out for is the presence of heavy metals. So heavy metals can come from growing cannabis in contaminated soil or using water that are polluted. And also, if the growing facility of cannabis is in proximity to an industrial factory that emits air pollution, or next to a train station, or just a highway, then pollution can come from the air, stain the cannabis flower, and then go on to the cannabis product. So here is a way to evaluate, for example, the soil that is being used. You can see that there are four heavy metals that are being monitored: the arsenic, the cadmium, the mercury, and the lead. You can see that all of them were present, although they were below below the limited amount. It was, they were still present, and the result was here in the next slide. You're going to see the flowers that were produced on this land, and you can see that the lead concentration were just 10 times more than the limit amount. That means that this cannabis sample failed and the entire batch needs to be disqualified. And that's why there are many limitations and restrictions on the soil that is allowed to be, that cannabis is allowed to grow on. For example, in Israel, it is mandatory to grow medicinal cannabis in detached soil in order for these failures not to occur. The third thing we need to notice is that cannabis is a plant and it suffers from mold, bacteria, yeast that are present on the flower, and these they also harm the quality of the flower, but can also result in the presence of toxins. So in order to monitor these pathogens on the plant, here is an example of a colony forming unit assay and you can see that the total aerobic bacterial count, the coliform, the yeast, and the mold are all below the limit. And the second sample here, you can see that this sample failed. The first sample passed, the second sample failed with very high results. So this sample of cannabis needs to be disqualified and cannot be administered to patients. The second thing we look out for is the presence of toxins. You can see here that the limited amount is very, very low, so the very low tolerance, 6 parts per billion, and it is monitored using an LC-MS/MS, and we look out for these mycotoxins, aflatoxins, toxins. The fourth thing that we need to pay attention to, and probably one of the most challenging, is the cannabinoid content. So first of all, you can see here that there are many different varieties of cannabis with the different morphological appearance, and this variation is also present in the cannabinoid content. So basically each cannabis plant has its own cannabinoid and terp profile, and which is more or less unique. And here is an example of how to evaluate the cannabinoid content. You see, this is a sample of a high THC cultivar. You can see that the THCA is the acidic form of THC is very high, 21.89. And you can see that the other cannabinoids are very low. You can see that there is no presence of a CBN, CBG or CBD. That means that this is a very fresh sample and the natural degradation haven't occurred yet. The second thing worth mentioning is that this number, the total potential THC and the total potential CBD, which is an aggregation of THC. For example, the total potential THC is an aggregation of the THC plus the estimated THC that will be yielded after THCA undergoes decarboxylation. So, and this is the number to pay attention to. Sometimes you can see misleading information where the total amount of THC is a copy-paste of the amount of THCA. And this is misleading information. We should always pay attention to the total potential of THC and CBD. Same goes here. You can see here a more detailed cannabinoid analysis. And here it's a CBD-rich cultivar. You can see that the dominated cannabinoid is cannabidiolic acid, CBDA. And again, we need to look out for the total potential CBD. You can see here that these total cannabinoids is not a very important figure, and the CBDA and CBD are being aggregated to this total potential CBD, which is the important number. And the process of the previous flowers, these flowers that had 13.83% CBD, they go to extraction. And here is the result, the yielding extracted of the CBD oil. You see that the total CBD is 51.4%, so it got really concentrated. And worth mentioning that the CBD levels, you can see the CBD to the CBDA ratio is very high. That means that most of the CBDA have been converted in the process of decarboxylation to CBD. And you can also see that THC is present. THC will always be present if it's a whole plant extract. It comes along with the CBD. And there is a little amount of CBG. And that's it. The fifth thing we need to pay attention to in order to ensure a safe cannabis product is that it doesn't have residual solvents in it. Residual solvents are a byproduct of the extraction method. There are many ways to extract cannabis using different kind of solvents. For example, isopropanol, ethanol, and these chemicals can stay in the oil and in the extraction. And here is an example. You can see that an example using a gas chromatography. You can see very apparent that there was methanol, ethanol, acetone, isopropanol, and a little bit of ethyl acetate. And this sample was failed because of high amounts of ethanol. And although it failed, there is a little bit of a judgment here, plays a room for some judgment, and knowing that ethanol is not a toxic substance, people consume very high amounts of it. It is not as dangerous as other molecules, like here, pten, xen, molecules that can be carcinogenic. So paying attention to the residual solvents is very important. These can also disqualify the use of the cannabis product. Thank you very much for listening to my lecture. Today we learn what is the medicinal grade cannabis product and all the information necessary to distinguish it using standard laboratory analysis practices. Thank you so much. Muito obrigado.